What's good, y'all? Rich Sosa coming back at y'all with another banger, man. Hey, yo, look, I just want to start this banger off as I do every single video with just giving y'all thanks to the Rich Gang family for always showing up and showing support, doing the most to always let me know that y'all are rocking with me throughout this journey. No matter how high or how low my sub count is, I already know I got the real ones with my back. And that's what I'm going to do with y'all. I'm going to put y'all on my back and bring y'all every single banger that I possibly can. But as you can see by the looks of the title and the screen, the build that I'm bringing y'all today is going to be the Stretch Glass Cleaner, y'all. This build, I'm telling y'all, is going to be really nice to use. It is literally probably one of the more better oversized guard builds that I have seen in every single 2K, y'all. This build is going to be able to do so many different things, especially when you have it in the hands of the right person. But before we get into this banger, y'all already know what y'all need to do. Be sure to hit that sub button if you're new. To all the supporters, run up those likes. Let's get 45 likes on this banger. Be sure to share it with your family and friends. And last but not least, y'all turn on those post notifications so y'all can see when I upload every single day. Now, when it comes to the position, we are going to be picking the power forward position, y'all. I am more than sure that you can make this build out of multiple different positions. But I'm telling y'all right now, the best version possible will be out of the small or power forward, y'all. Preferably, I'm going to go with power forward, but I'm telling y'all, you can make this build out of the small forward right now. Just depends on your preference liking. If y'all want that kind of video for the small forward version, go ahead and drop a like on this banger right now. But as y'all can see, with the height, we're going to be going with 6'8", weight of 210, and the max out wingspan of 7'6". We're going to go with the built for this build. And as you can see already, there is a lot of potential when it comes to this build, y'all. Now, first thing that y'all going to want to do is upgrade your driving layup, y'all. With these stats, you have to be very specific, or it is easily possible to get a different type of build name, y'all. Now, we're going to put our driving layup to a 93, driving dunk at 95. We're going to skip our standing dunk because I want to be able to use some post moves with this build. So you could go max post control if you want to, or at 82 to get exactly 15 finishing badges, y'all. You see the difference? If you do take some off, you will be risking losing some of your Hall of Fame badges for gold badges, and there is no point in doing that. So we're going to put our post control at an 83, actually. When it comes to the shooting, by all means, max these out. We're going to max out our mid-range at an 86, three-pointer at an 81, and our free throw at a 64, y'all. When it comes to the pass accuracy, go ahead and put that at 62. We're going to, of course, max out the ball handle at 76 and speed with ball at 79, y'all. For the perimeter defense, y'all want to go ahead and put that at 87. With your steal, you're going to go ahead and put that at exactly 85, y'all. When it comes to the block, we're going to max that out at 95. And, of course, we are going to do the same exact thing when it comes to our defensive and offensive rebound, both at 95, y'all. Speed is going to be maxed out at 82. Acceleration, we're going to do the same exact thing, maxed out at 79. Our strength, I'm really excited about the strength because at 99, we're going to have 80 strength. So go ahead and put that at 72. Vertical is going to be an 88, and our stamina is going to be a 90, y'all. Now, you could drop any one of these attributes as long as you maintain the same amount of badge points. And then from there, what you want to do is put your stamina to a 91, so that way at 99 plus gym rat, you're going to be able to have exactly 99 stamina, y'all. So again, it all comes down based to preference with what y'all want to do when it comes to making these kind of builds. But I'm telling y'all, I'm only bringing y'all the latest. I'm bringing y'all the greatest, the rarest, and the best builds in all of NBA 2K21, y'all. Now, when it comes to the takeovers, of course, we get the slashing, we get the sharpshooting, we also get the lockdown and the glass cleaning, of course, y'all. To be a straight up stretch glass cleaner, you could easily pick limitless range takeover as well as see the future takeover. But the good thing about this build, you can even choose lockdown takeover as well, y'all. It really all comes based on preference with what y'all want to do. But again, for me personally, I would feel like lockdown takeover or see the future. I'm going to go with enhanced jump shot contest. And as you can see, we get a legit stretch glass cleaner, y'all. Anthony Davis, Giannis, Chris Webber. I'm telling y'all, this is a really nice oversized guard that can definitely run the one And there is no weaknesses when it comes to this build, I'm telling y'all. Now, let's go ahead and check out what this build is going to look a little bit like when it comes to hitting 99, y'all. So look, your speed is going to get boosted. Once you get 99 plus gym rat, you're going to have a 90 speed. Acceleration is going to be an 87. We're going to have an 80 strength, a 96 vertical, and 99 stamina, y'all. When it comes to our rebounding for offense and defense and our block, y'all, we're going to have a 99. Steal is going to be a 90, and our perimeter defense is going to go up to a 91. With our ball handle, we're going to get exactly 80 to lock those pro dribble moves. Speed with ball is going to be an 83. Our three-pointer is going to be an 85, and our midi is going to be a 90, y'all. But again, we're going to have an 87 post control, 99 driving dunk, and a 96 driving layup, y'all. I'm telling y'all, that is not even including boost, and that's another plus 5. Y'all could do the math with that, but just think of how goaded this build is going to be once it's all said and done. For the finishing, of course, you want to throw on the main badge that you have to prioritize. That's going to be Posterizer and Hall of Fame, as well as Pro Touch on either gold or Hall of Fame. It comes down to with what y'all want to do. You could even go with silver as well. But I'm going to go with Fearless Finisher as well as Postman Technician because we are part post score. And I'm going to throw on Lob City Finisher just so we don't struggle with getting those alley-oop animations. Now, when it comes to the shooting, max out your deep threes as well as your hot zone hunter, y'all. Now, the rest from here is solely based on preference. You're going to be able to dribble with this build, so I would go with Rhythm Shooter on Hall of Fame or even Hot Shot. And another one you could go with is going to be Catch and Shoot and Corner Specialist, either both on bronze or silver, or one silver and one bronze. And you could even throw in Hot Shot on silver or bronze. It comes down to what y'all want to do. I'm just giving y'all some ideas. But other than that, another badge you could go with is going to be Green Machine. And that is some of the better badges that I would use when it comes to using any build as well as this build. Now, when it comes to the playmaking, of course you want handles for days as well as quick first step. Those are both on Hall of Fame. So now we're left with one badge that we could put on Hall of Fame, or four different bronze badges, or even two silver, y'all. When it comes down to my preference, I would go with tight handles if it works. Or if you want to break ankles, you could go with gold ankle breaker. But a good one that I think is nice to use is going to be unpluckable. But again, I feel like you don't need it on Hall of Fame. So I'm going to go with silver bailout as well as silver unpluckable. And when it comes to the defense, y'all, we have a lot of badges that we're going to use. We're going to go with Intimidator on Hall of Fame for sure. We're also going to run Rebound Chaser as well as Rim Protector, y'all. So that is a lot of badges already off rip that we can use on Hall of Fame. Unfortunately, we cannot get clamps on Hall of Fame for this build. So any other badges that you want to throw on, again, will be perfectly fine. Let's say you don't want to run clamps. I highly don't recommend that, but you don't need to if you want to get only Hall of Fame badges, y'all. So I would go with clamps, gold, and honestly, bronze interceptor. And then from there, I'm going to go with pogo stick as well as tireless defender on Hall of Fame. And you could even go with defensive leader. You could go with box. Even heart crusher is a really good one, or even chase down artist, y'all. You could really do anything that you want to. I feel like worm is a really good badge. Clutch defender is a nice one too. I'm going to go with that. And as you can see, we have a total between our finishing and defense, 9 Hall of Fame badges. Adding the shooting and playmaking, that is 12 in total. Thank y'all so much for watching this entire video through. I just want to say thank y'all to the Riz Gang family for always showing up and showing out. Thank y'all who are new for showing y'all amazing love, showing y'all amazing support. And I'm going to continue to bring y'all on this journey with me, y'all. We are going to be hitting 10K very soon, y'all. So with all that being said, man, y'all already know what y'all need to do. Be sure to hit that sub button if you're new, y'all. Let's go ahead and ramp those likes. Let's get 45 likes on this banger. Be sure to share it with your family and friends. And last but not least, y'all, turn on post notice so y'all can see when I upload every single day. Man, with all that being said, I got one last thing to say. Rich out.